So now with the whole, you know, people trying to get into immigration situation, like you just mentioned that that people should, if you're here already, right. You suggest that people should try to get their citizenship.
Yeah, I think it's very important. I think, like we see with, you know, Buju is about ready to come out of jail.
Right.
Mark Anthony Myrie. I don't have a real accent, but I fake like I have an accent. But Mark Anthony Myrie, about, I think, December 8th, they said, of this year. Right. They're about ready to release him. And we know why he got locked up for. But I think it's very important for all of our Caribbean people and all of our people that are immigrants to this country. A lot of us have this self-pride about where we come from, and I don't want to have, you know, and I don't want to be a citizen of this country and so forth and so on. But there's a thing in this country right now where people are being deported. And a lot of times children are brought here when they're 1, 2 years old, and the parents never move on making the children citizens. You only have a green card, you're a resident, and then you get into any type of trouble and you get deported, and you're sending a child back to a place that he or she knows nothing about. You know, so I think that the wise thing for people to do is to get that citizenship. You know, it's a little bit more of a secure thing. I'll give you a little story. You know, me and my brother, we weren't born in this country. We from Panama. And we had my brother had to renew his license for his job. He was working at MTA at that time. And they wouldn't let him renew his license because his green card was expiring like in 2 months. Yeah. So at that point, we understood that it was time to make a decision and become citizens, just to protect what we had, to protect families, and to not be having that separation of family. A lot of it has to do with that. Buju gonna get deported back to Jamaica because obviously he was here all them years, and he was here long enough to put in for citizenship. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he ever applied for one or if he ever did anything like that, but I think that citizenship is very important, and I think that's an important topic that we need to talk about that our people don't look into.
You know, the thing I think about was, you know, artists, you know, Buju, a lot of people.
Right.
I think, you know, when they're in the status of traveling here to make money, traveling here to perform, the work visa was very easy for them to get, as opposed to trying to, you know, to come here, you got to come here, be here for a certain amount of time, go through a whole process to get citizenship, as opposed to you come to do a show, get your work visa, easy. So I think that because of the process at the time for getting a work visa was easier, well, it still technically is easier than getting a citizenship, which is why a lot of the artists never got their citizenship. I know people like Mavado and, you know, other people, they got married here.
Supercat got his citizenship.
So, you know,
and I think Shava got his citizenship.
Yeah. Because they were making they were really making money. They weren't just coming here to do shows. Like, this is like their second home. So, like, for them, it was like.
But I mean, Buju was that dude, you know, Mr. Gargamel. We was young teenagers. He was on the same level as those guys. You get what I'm saying? I think it's a pride thing, like, you know, and that's one of the things that we have to forsake, like that pride. Like, our people have this pride thing, this pride issue about, you know, I'm Jamaican and I'm gonna remain Jamaican. Yeah, you can have dual citizenship, but it don't matter. You know, you at some point you gotta use wisdom. Right. You know, you gotta use your wisdom and go out there and do the things that are gonna safeguard you and your family. You know, so if you got children out there and you might not want to be a citizen, you are proud to be whatever it is that you are, at least safeguard your children if you brought them here young and make them go forward and get that citizenship so that they won't be suffering later in life. Go ahead.
Like Bernie Blaze, she mentioned that, you know, citizenship can be revoked if you commit a felony.
Nah. Citizenship is revoked if you are an enemy of the state. You gotta be like a guy who's like a terrorist, or you lied on your application. I never heard of anyone citizenship being revoked because of a felony. I heard of your green card being revoked. Mm. if you commit a felony. You understand what I'm saying? I haven't heard about your citizenship being revoked, because remember, when you become a citizen, now you pledge of allegiance to this land.
Right.
But a resident is really just a person who's permitted to work here. Right. You pay taxes, but you just a resident. You live here, you know. But now I can't say that I've heard all the cases, right. But I haven't heard a case where a citizenship has been revoked from a felony. I know people that have gone to jail, not born in this country, but a citizen, committed felonies and are released into the population because they're a citizen of the United States. So it could be revoked if you are a resident. That's what I know. Your green card could be taken away.
So now Renee asks, and it's a hypothetical question, but she asks, why aren't the Canadian borders being blocked the same way that the Mexican borders are being blocked?
Why aren't the Canadian borders being blocked?
Yeah.
Because Canada doesn't have the issues that the U.S. have with migrants, I think. You know, most people, when they come through a Mexican border, they just settle in the U.S.
Yeah.
I know when ICE was running around and grabbing people up, there were a lot of people running up to Canada, and Canada was letting, you know, a good amount of people in. But I think that's the issue. You know, America is sold throughout the world as the land of opportunity. You know, where you could raise your family and you could make a better future for your family. So I think that's the main point, that people come here, they feel like this is the land of opportunity, and once they get here, they'll try to find a way.
The Gallery every Tuesday. Miss Stacy Nicole Renee and Bad Man Benny.